It looks like you outsmarted me.
Butthead turkey's hanging around outside my garden. Hi! You want to come in and kick my butt? Is that what it is? Ooh. He doesn't look happy today. How you doing? Uh-oh. Let's go this way. Now let's go this way. Would you like a piece of grass? Piece of grass? No? Kick my butt? Kick my butt? Yeah. Beat me up? Not a bird! You're a food item! You're a food item! Yeah, you better run. Nice day out here today. Partly cloudy, breezy, really nice. Garden's looking good. Can't wait till the rabbits are out of the garden. I want to mow this. I don't like having really tall grass in here. Makes for room for the grasshoppers to hide, and they just chew the heck out of the garden. Well, you can see how big the pea pods got. Pea plants are about, I'd say, 7 feet tall now. The post for the pea pods is around 4 feet high, so you can see that the pea plants got about 7 feet tall. It's just crazy. I think they're going to stop. I hope they're going to stop. And check it out. They've been flowering like crazy, and it's hard to see them on camera, of course, but there's pea pods all over the place. I wish I would have done a video earlier to show a lot more of the flowers, but they're still flowering. I mean, they haven't even stopped. They won't stop until early fall. But it's going to be like this for the rest of the summer. Pea pods everywhere. And I just picked these 2 days ago. And yeah, look at them. They're everywhere. They're from like little baby ones. These are my favorite because you could just eat them right off the plant. They're tender. They make great stir fries. And I pick them about every 2 days now, and yeah, it even grows on the other side of the fence. They're just everywhere. Not very many plants. I mean, this is only about a 3 to 4 foot long row that I planted up against the fence. They grow through the fence, over the fence. I even let weeds grow up around there because they'll just grab the weed and use it to grow up and then kill the weed. Check out the beans. They're doing really well. Let me go around the other side. The pole beans are growing right next to the pea pods. Last time I showed you, they were just a few feet tall, but if I give you a close-up look, hopefully I got some focus going on here. Flowers everywhere. These things are just covered in flowers. Even underneath the leaves, inside flowers, we're talking hundreds upon hundreds of beans. And they're actually showing off some beans. They're showing some beans right now. Itty-bitty ones, but they're everywhere. They go a little bit slower than the pea pods, but they're every bit as crazy when they start putting out. And the thing with the beans and the peas, if you're growing them yourself, if you've never grown them before, pick them as much as you possibly can, because the more you pick, the more they'll put out. They'll put out runners. Every time you pick them clean, you go out there, you go out and check out your pea pods, and you see flowers all over the place. And you think, ooh, this is cool. You go out a couple days later, you're like, oh, holy crap, pea pods everywhere. Pick, 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 pick. Then you go out 2 more days later, and you think that you might see 1 or 2, and there's even more. It's like this crazy pyramid effect. I love these things. They're delicious. The pea pods are great for summer eating. I don't preserve them because I've never had much luck with them. I tried canning them once. Yeah, nobody told me that you can't can pea pods. Man, that was a nasty, icky mess. You can freeze them, but I don't use them in the winter time. I like them fresh. The beans, I definitely preserve those. I'm going to blanch them off and freeze them. Here's an update on the peppers. The pepper plants are huge. They're doing wonderful. There's some peppers right there. They're doing really good. I've totally cleaned these plants off twice now in the last 2 weeks, and they're putting out even more. And they just absolutely will not stop. I heard somebody say in one of their videos that pepper plants in the heat of the summer will stop flowering and putting out peppers. These are slowing down with the flowers, but not stopping at all, not even close. But they're kind of going a little bit slower than they were because of the heat of the summer, but not a problem. They're actually strengthening their roots. They're putting out more leaves and growing, so I know that when it starts cooling down a little bit, they're going to go crazy again. So I've been eating peppers and everything I could possibly imagine using peppers for. And as if those peppers weren't enough, here's the ones I grew from seed, those little tiny plants I showed you last time. They're not putting out any peppers yet. They're just getting ready with the heat of the sun. It's a good thing they're not. But they're getting ready, so in the late summer when it cools down a little bit, early fall, they're going to put out tons of them. And then these are the eggplants, these huge, weird-looking things. They're going to be putting out eggplants, and they're doing really wonderful. There's that big mess of a plant. It's out of control. The squash, the yellow long neck squash or something like that. It's a zucchini. Inside you'll see a whole bunch of them. These are about, I don't know, 4 to 5 inches long. No, 3 to 5 inches long. I don't let them grow very long. I pick them when they're about that long and then just slice them up real small and throw them into stir fries. I'm sure I'm going to let some of them get bigger, but for right now I'm getting so many of them every few days, I can pick them when they're that young and use them in stir fries. Tomatoes! Yep, remember there was a video I did not too long ago, maybe a couple weeks ago, on pinching back your tomatoes. This is the Roma tomato. It started vining out towards the bottom. I clipped off a lot of the branches because I wanted to get some sunlight down to those lower branches so they grow a little bit better. And what happened is one of these branches right here, it came out of the main plant, swooped down, touched the ground, and where it touched the ground, I put dirt over it. And what it did was shoot down some roots out of that section, and then the part that came up got even stronger, and it's got flowers all over the place. I prefer these other plants. They're hybrids or some sort. I think this Roma tomato is heirloom. A lot of people like heirlooms for flavor, but the thing with heirlooms is they're usually less disease resistant, and I would just hate to have a tomato plant go to hell because of diseases, and it just starts spreading, it gets out of control. It's just kind of depressing. These other plants, I believe they're hybrids, they're called Bush Goliath, but they have monstrous amounts of tomatoes. We'll see. If they taste really good, I know that they put out a lot of tomatoes. But if they taste good, I'm going to save the seeds and grow them again next year. Here's another shot of them. These are the Bush Goliath cherry. They have tons of them on there. And then here's the little orphan plant that I was talking about. Want to see something really crazy? Remember the cucumbers? Check it out. They're going everywhere. They just went hog wild. I couldn't stop them. I tried to keep the vines inside the container. I thought, you know, I'm only going to have 4 plants in there. How big can they possibly get? I don't think you want to ask that when it comes to cucumbers. The pickling cucumbers are actually the fastest growing and the fastest producing. They are prolific like you wouldn't believe. But the straight 8, I believe, is what they're called. The slicing ones. They're putting out, I've been harvesting cucumbers, by the way, all over. These aren't my first ones. But the cucumber plants are putting out tons of them right there. I picked a whole Tupperware container of these things yesterday. And cucumbers are wonderful. When you're starting a garden, you think, ooh, cucumbers, that's going to be so cool. I'm going to have cucumbers all over the place. I can hardly wait. Well, they are delicious, I got to admit. But one thing about cucumbers is once they start coming in, they just won't stop. And you think, oh, crap, how am I supposed to eat all of these things? And so you start giving them to your family. There's some more. You start giving them to your family, you start eating them as fast as you can, and then eventually, like with me, I grow so many, I don't pickle them, by the way, I'm just really bad at pickling. I tried it 1 year, and they were awful. People were just being nice and taking the jars of cucumbers off my, pickles off my hands, and I think they threw them away. But after a while, I toss them to the chickens, and I toss them to the dogs. The dogs love cucumbers. I'll be showing that on a video, too. They actually stand outside the garden and wait for cucumbers to be tossed over the edge. Same thing with the tomatoes. When I get too many tomatoes, sometimes I'll just throw them over the fence because there's enough for everybody. I throw some to the chickens, some to the dogs, and they run around and eat cucumbers. It gives them gas, but then again, they're not indoor dogs.